Yes, it is the review, the classic review of the very first movie in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. This is Iron Man. 2008 was, in my opinion, one of the most pivotal years for superhero movies in general because of two releases. The Dark Knight, the second in the Christopher Nolan Batman trilogy, and Iron Man. When you look at all the factors that went into Iron Man the movie, it should have been a flop. Number one, it was based on a superhero that not many people had known. When you think Marvel, you get your X-Men, Spider-Man, maybe a Hulk fan here or there, maybe Daredevil. But Iron Man, even though he was a popular character, especially to the hardcores, and even though he had his own cartoon, Iron Man just wasn't at the level of some of the other characters, like I mentioned. Like, he wasn't Wolverine, he wasn't Spider-Man, he wasn't Hulk or any of those other characters. He was Iron Man. And again, cool character on his own, but not to the level that you would think, oh, a $1 billion franchise is going to be built off of. So that's factor number one. Number two, it was Jon Favreau, the director. Now, Jon Favreau, he had directed Elf. He had experience as a director and an actor, but this was something that was just on a whole new scale and on a whole new level. And so his inexperience on that level, that could have caused the movie to be a flop. And finally, the star of the movie, Robert Downey Jr. Again, nobody questions the acting ability of Robert Downey Jr. He is one of the best actors of his generation and still one of the best actors going today, Doolittle aside. But at that time he had so many personal problems with legal issues, substance abuse. Like, dude was just getting in all sorts of trouble, and people, he could have went down that Nick Nolte path where he's just not in a lot of stuff. He could have went down the path that a lot of 80 stars went down, just drugged out and career's over with, bloated, and now he's just, doing random cameo appearances on USA and TNT dramas. That could have been Robert Downey Jr., but that's not what happened. Everything worked out for the movie, the timing, the effects, everything worked out, and eventually we got what we have today, the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Something that I like, and as I'm going back and watching some of these older MCU movies, especially like those Phase 1, Phase 2 movies, I like the character that the movies had. Something that I don't like with the modern day MCU movies, Iron Man in particular, it's the look of the suit. I think the suits looked cooler, in Iron Man, Iron Man 2, and Avengers and Iron Man 3, because they still felt practical. They still felt, real. Like, that's real metal, that's real everything on those suits. And that's something that I don't get with those modern, everything past Iron Man 3. It just felt, even though all of this is fake, it just didn't feel, as genuine as those other suits did. And that's something that I kind of miss. I also want to give credit to Jon Favreau because the movie really does feel like his, even though it's eventually, and I think that helps that it's the first one. The movie had a certain charm to it, and I think, it had a certain grit to it. Even though we got the tease of the Avengers at the very end in one of the best post, in my opinion, that's a top five MCU post-credit scene. The first Iron Man, there's just something special about it. It feels raw a little bit because it's not as polished as those other movies. It feels a little more gritty with how it looks, and the acting about it is, even though, again, all of these are really talented, some of these guys have won Oscars, some of these guys have, been nominated and everything like that, but there's just something special about this first one. The performances, Robert Downey Jr., fantastic job as Iron Man. Had he done a poor job, had they picked anyone else, I don't think the MCU would be what it is today. I think they maybe would have went to the first Avengers movie and we wouldn't have what we have today. I think, off the back of a very good, charismatic actor, they were able to build something special. And Robert Downey Jr. brought so much energy, so much character into Iron Man, so much so that his performance has actually influenced other cartoons, the comics. He's become sort of the definitive version of what we think of as Iron Man, even though there's been tons and tons of Iron Man stories before this movie came out. Robert Downey Jr. really did give Iron Man the character, his own unique feel. There's also Gwyneth Paltrow, who played Pepper Potts. I think she did really good as well. Some of the MCU love interests, the love stories are not as good. I'm not as interested or invested in, but I do like that they kind of built up the Pepper Tony dynamic over these movies. And they did feel like a real genuine couple once we got to, Endgame and everything and what ended up happening. But I like the dynamic that Gwyneth brought. She was professional, but she also had a vulnerability that worked out really well for her as Pepper. John Favreau, he had his own little role as Happy. He's not as involved in this movie as he would be eventually in some of those other movies, but I liked him in this as well. Jeff Bridges as the main antagonist as Obadiah Stane, aka Ironmonger. He was good as well. He's one of my favorite MCU villains. He's got a slickness to him. He's badass without being like overstated. And he's just, he's a sneaky, shady businessman. Kind of a throwback to what those businessmen in movies in the 80s were like. He is really good in this movie. And, Jeff Bridges, he plays it so cool. He's a bad guy, but you know what? You'd still trust him, even though you know he's gonna betray you. You'd still trust him. He's cool in this role. Then we come to the role of James Rhodes. In this movie, the only movie where he's not Don Cheadle, played by Terrence Howard. And this is kind of a hot take, but I think I like Terrence Howard as Rhodey more than Don Cheadle. I like the dot the Don't get me wrong. I like Don Cheadle as an actor. I think he's fantastic, and I like his chemistry with Tony and then all the other Avengers as we go through. But I love the dynamic in this particular movie between Terrence Howard and between Robert Downey Jr. as Rhodey and Tony. I think he has that stern, strict, not to be messed with vibe to him that really does do a huge service to the character itself, because Rhodey, he is a serious, Air Force colonel. He's supposed to have some gravitas to him. And while Don Cheadle, again, he does have that authority, I don't think he has it to the level that Terrence Howard has. There's some sternness to this version of Rhodey that we don't quite get in the other movies as we go throughout the MCU. He's good, so good in this movie, and I do kind of wish, and I am interested in how, the vibe of the MCU would have been had Terrence Howard was able to stay along, had he been able to work things out with, whether it's the contract, who knows? I think he would have brought a different vibe to the entire movie. It would have been interesting to see him in Civil War when Rhodey, gets paralyzed, but he gets fixed in the end. But I think that would have been interesting to see how Terrence Howard would have played that out. And it's one of those things that when you look back on the MCU, you look back on how it was all built, how everything was conquered. It is one of those where it's just like, man, you wish that things maybe worked out in a different way with a different actor. You kind of see that with Ed, with the dynamic of Ed Norton and Mark Ruffalo as the Hulk. But we'll get to that another time. The music in the movie, all of it, a lot of rock, some AC/DC, some Black Sabbath, great musical choices in the movie. There's sort of a dark edge to the movie as well because he is literally going overseas and fighting terrorism, and destroying those weapons. The character of Jensen was really good in the movie as well, although, looking back on the MCU as a whole, I think it was cool that he had his little cameo in Iron Man 3. But it is really strange to me that He never, like, Iron Man never really did bring him up again. Like, he was just, like, they kind of just forgot about him and brushed him off. And I think that's weird because Jensen was so critical and so crucial in this first movie with saving the life of Iron Man that it's just like, why was he never mentioned again? That's a little bit weird for me. And I do wish that he, maybe, they got a dog and he named it Jensen or something like that. Just a little small head nod to the person who really did help save his life and really did help, start him on that path to becoming a better person and eventually what he would do to save the universe. And so, yeah, Iron Man 1, still to me, top to bottom, it's on that Mount Rushmore. It's a top five MCU movie. I think it holds up the effects of the suit to me. I think they've gotten a little bit worse in those recent movies, but it I love that suit look. I love the effect of the suit, the flight. Everything is so good. There's so many great scenes in the movie. There's him taking flight and learning how to fly and really assemble the suit for the first time. There's him going around and shooting the tank with the missile, then turning his back and walking away. Him destroying all those weapons. The one part that I would say is kind of a dud is the finale. And I can't be too critical on it because this particular finale did, influence several of the finales. There's elements of this finale in a lot of other MCU movies. The blue light being going up into the sky, the whole fight with an evil version of yourself that we saw in later MCU movies that was established here as well. But overall, this is one of those where I think I can see it, 10 times in the same day and still not get tired of it. It's still such an excellent movie, so well put together. It's a big hats off to everybody who was a part of the production, the writing. Everybody did a great job on this particular movie, and it is fun to go back to a simpler time in not just the MCU, but superhero movies in general, where we are able to have the scale lowered just a bit. To something a little bit more simple. And it is one of those things that kind of takes you back to a particular time. 2008, it was, the year my mom passed away. It was me heading into my senior year in high school. It was sort of a time of transition for me. And I think, this is one of those movies that it's always going to have that special place to it because of where I was in my life at that time and where movies in general were. I think this and The Dark Knight, like I said, these two movies were so critical in really firming up and establishing superhero movies as the viable genre that it is today. And imagine if Iron Man flopped. Imagine if The Dark Knight was just not that good of a movie. Where would we be, in the culture? Like, there'd be, I think, Paramount probably would have kept making Iron Man movies, but they probably wouldn't have been as good as what we eventually got. We probably wouldn't have ended up getting the MCU that we got or Captain America. Like, there's so many things that we wouldn't have gotten had this one movie flopped, had this one movie been a failure. And so I got to give a ton of credit to Jon Favreau, every producer, Kevin Feige, Robert Downey Jr., especially for no, without those guys, we wouldn't have the MCU that we have today. So yeah, I give this one, it's a 10 out of 10. I love this movie. Still one of my favorite superhero movies, one of the best movies in the MCU, period. Yeah, that's it for me. That's it for the review. Make sure if you got Disney Plus, if you got it on DVD, Blu-ray, digital, whatever, go watch Iron Man. It's still a great time, even 12 years after it first came out. It's still a fantastic movie. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe this video, as well as my channel. Turn on the little bell so that you can be on alert for all of my new videos and postings. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Jamel727. Be on the lookout for more reviews, more gameplay. I'm gonna start doing a lot more stuff on the channel as well. So, you guys stay safe, wash your damn hands, follow any orders you're getting to be locked down, stay the hell in the house. Everything else can wait. The parties can wait, the barbecues, cookouts, all of that can wait. let's stay inside, make sure you keep your hands clean, and let's try and get through the whole Rona thing together. This is 2020 is going to be a weird year. So, yeah, you guys have a great rest of your day. Peace, and I'll catch you next time.